everybody, my name is Python and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Survival. Hopefully you guys are having a fantastic day, and what you're seeing right now is me force growing the turtles to get the scoots. And also, those guys are now going to breed up and then we will have ourselves a proper turtle breedery of awesomeness. So there we go, guys. We've got our first four turtle scoots of the series. In fact, to tell you the truth, I think this is the first ever time I've gotten turtle scoots. So, yeah, this is pretty epic, huh? So all we're going to do at this point is wait for these guys to, you know, finish off their freaking, sand party over there. What is going on with you guys? Got to wait for them to finish off their sand party, and then they should be able to lay their eggs, and then we go about our day, and then we wait for them to hatch again, right? That's basically what we've got to do, yeah? But anyways, guys, as always, if you want to support this series, do be sure to drop a like rating and consider joining us by either subscribing or by hitting that join button on the channel. I thought I'd begin with the turtles here because, you know, this is like the finale of the turtle saga here, huh? All we got to do now is really just, you know, wait for these guys to breed up and put their eggs down and do all sorts of stuff. I don't know what these guys are doing. They're just sort of, I don't know. We've got two pregnant turtles here. Hey, baby. Awesome. Right, I'm going to pick these bad boys up. Thank you. Wait, where's the second one? There it is. Okay, right. So we've still got a pregnant turtle here, yeah? And you should, like, do your own thing, I think. Not unless I... Oh, wait. Oh, these guys didn't get to breed in time. Or did they? I don't know. I don't know what's going on. All right, well, you do your own thing. We're going to get ourselves some more eggies out of this in just a second here. And hey! Right, how many did you get? I need to wait for them to move off because otherwise there may be a slight chance of... What? You're hatching some too? What? Okay, Oh, no! I think the turtles just ran over their own egg. Oh, man, I should have five right now, but I don't. Okay, right. Well, these guys need to, like, you know, leave the eggs alone to do their thing, right? Yeah? Come on. Was there still one that was pregnant? Yeah, this one's pregnant, isn't it? The ones that look fatter. I don't know. Well, gosh freaking darn! We got 10 turtle eggs! 10! We got to... Oh, they're still going! What the heck, bro? How many more times do you need to go? These guys are just pumping out eggs like there's no tomorrow. Oh, there we go. Right, how many was in that one? I don't actually... Wait, are you breeding again? There's another fat turtle. Oh, my gosh. Was that just one? Yeah, it was just one. Okay. Oh, my goodness me. Like, these guys are just pumping them out. What the heck's wrong with them? They're literally just pumping them out. All right, folks. So, 14 turtle eggs. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do your thing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do your thing. We'll have a 3 over here. 1, 2, 3. And then we'll have a 1. Oh. Hello? Oh, no. There's still 3. 1, 2, 3. Boom. Right. Yes. Right. Now we've just got to sort of stay around here a bit. Apparently, turtle eggs that are near each other will reportedly hatch quicker. So, actually... Just to go ahead and do that. Oh, no, I think I broke one. Oh, dang blast it. Maybe we'll just put them all next to each other and see if that theory is correct. I want to see. I want to see if that is actually the case. So, break that one. Break that one. So, yeah, I've got 6. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Right. Okay, so, if my theory is correct and the wiki is correct, then these things should hatch fairly quickly. I guess we can't sleep anymore, though, again. Hey! So, after just the first night... In fact, this first night isn't even over yet. Hey! Two of them have already gone ahead and got cracks in them. Okay, that's pretty epic. Hey! Alright, so, if it keeps up with this, then we're going to have ourselves a massive swarm of baby turtles. Ah, I can think of worse things to happen. Well, anyways, guys, yeah, I think we'll leave the turtles for today, and we will move on to something else. There's a few things I want to do today. I think one of them is going to be we go ahead and finish off this birch district, and in addition to that, I think it'll be nice to finally get some shepherd villagers inside of our woodland mansion so they are ready to trade the wool. We have lots of wool, guys. We should probably trade it and get emeralds. Seems like a good idea, doesn't it? So, yeah, I think I mentioned before, I want to make the little trading hall over there. And I still want to do that. So, let's grab for ourselves some of these dark oak planks. And yeah, we should be able to make ourselves a bit of a thing. Also, there's a large area here. I'll probably do something with that as well. But in the meantime, guys, what I want to do real quick is I just want to go ahead and block this off again. And here we go. This is the room we have to work with, ladies and gentlemen. All we have to do is figure out a little bit of a layout, figure out how many shepherds we want in here, and sort of go at it from there, I guess. I mean, we could maybe even have two levels of villagers. But do we want to do that? I'm not entirely sure, to be honest with you guys. Alrighty, guys. So a little bit of progress has been made here, and I have made space for 6 shepherds. So we're going to have one in there, one in there, 2 at the back here, 1 over here, and of course, 1 over here. So yeah, that makes 6. And what we need to do now is try to continue the pathway decoration. So we're going to put down some white wool, rather like this, in the floor. And it should look pretty darn nice as a result of us doing that. So just a few more bits to go. Apparently we're setting up celebratory fireworks, because why not? And here we go. Yeah, all right. So all we got to do now is we need to figure out what we're going to do for the rest of this. So let's grab for ourselves some of these dark oak planks, and I just want to like do something here. Maybe something like that, nice and simple, you know, nothing too difficult, I guess. Maybe a little arch type thing. Oh gosh, I really messed this up, didn't I? Right, boom, there you go. Nice little arch type thing so the villagers can't get through. And then we can, like, you know, no matter where they are, we can still trade with them. Or better still, if we really wanted to do something smart, we could probably, hang on a minute, do a little something. And then we place in a fence gate there, and then we can walk up against the fence gate. And then no matter where they are inside of their pod, I should be able to go ahead and, you know, trade with them no matter what. So, yeah. Okay, coolio. Ah, we got it figured out, huh? All right. You'll love to see it. Okay, so let's go ahead and do a little thing like that. Okay, that's looking pretty cool. And then we need to go ahead and, like, decorate the top sections. Probably going to go ahead and put some of our, you know, fan art stuffs down there. I think that'll look pretty cool. So, yeah, right. Do that. And then that's actually too high, isn't it? So it needs to be here. Yeah. Alright, we're getting there, guys. We're getting there. So after this, we'll actually get the shepherds in themselves. And then we'll have to breed them up as well, of course, because we only have, I think, 2 or something like that. I can't remember, if I'm honest with you guys. So, yeah, anyways, let's go ahead and get the rest of this done. And let's get the beds in, get the workstations in, and then all that's left to do, like I say, is get the actual villagers. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. 6 pods. I decided to randomize the layout of each one just to make it look a little bit more interesting. So all we got to do now is actually get the villagers in themselves. So all we need to do is grab ourselves the minecarts and rails, and we need to make a minecart track. Yes. Moving villagers again. Yay! I love moving villagers. One of my favorite pastimes. If you can't tell already, that's sarcasm. I hate moving villagers, man. All right, well, we've got to do it anyway. So here we go. So rails. More rails, please. Yep, there we go. And then just a whole bunch of minecarts. Okay. Hopefully, shouldn't be too difficult. Well, guys, to be honest with you, so far, this has actually been mostly painless. All we got to do is keep pushing these guys along, get them all the way to the back of the mansion, and then go from there. Right, okay, so... Oh, jeez. Uh-oh. Hello. You need to die, sir. Oh, jeez. Get out! Sucker! What you doing? Hey, buddy. Hey. You're going the wrong way. Go on, back over that way. Go on, then. There you go, brother. Coolio! Right, I mean, you're getting there. Slowly but surely, you're getting there. Come on, then, Mr. Villager. Number 1. We've got 1 out of 6 shepherds. We've got a second one, and then we need to, I guess, breed these guys up. So here you go. In you go. And then... Yep, you are now inside your pod, so I can now, A, break this so I can put the wall back up, right? And then here we go. And boop! Yay! Villager number 1! Awesome! This is sick! All right, guys, we're getting there. Let's see if we can't get ourselves some more in there. All right, folks. Well, actually, that took nowhere near as much time as I thought it would. And that is because a lot of the villagers that were inside of that villager house, the villager breeding house, they were actually unemployed slash not traded with, so then I could make them unemployed and then I could convert them into shepherds. So all we need to do now is try to lock in some of the trades, and then for all of the other ones where I don't really have that ability, we just wait for them to refresh them to give white wool, because white wool is what we have in abundance at the moment, right? And well, you know, the other types of wool you can actually pay them pay them towards to get emeralds from. Wait, that sentence went wrong. Basically, you can only trade white, brown, gray, and black wool to get emeralds in. You can't actually trade all of the colors. So, yeah. I mean, it is a bit sucky that that's the case, but I'm not too fussed about it. So, yeah, we can actually do a little bit of trading here, my friends. Awesome. All right, so here we go. Let's get ourselves some XP and emeralds. Look at that. Oh, my gosh. You can trade 18 times? What? Or can you, like, go ahead and do other stuff? Uh-huh. Yeah, he's already, like... Oh, my God. He's already filled himself back up again. Oh, my gosh. 25 emeralds. Okay, you're going to rank yourself up again? Shepherd, no. You're still an apprentice. Okay, fair enough. All right, you do you there, brother. What else have we got? There's another white trade over here. Yeah, maybe we wait this time to trade. Okay, so... Oh, this one's selling carpets. Okay. I'm kind of all right with that. Don't mind if I do. 47 emeralds is now the amount we're at. You've still only got an iron crest, so that's fine. That one's selling shears. Okay, you don't get very much XP towards leveling up, though. Again, that one's got black wool. Uh-huh. What if I was to go ahead and buy some of these? Although then again, it doesn't really give that much XP. So, according to the wiki, the stuffs you can buy from shepherds later on, yeah, you can buy carpets, you can buy coloured wool, you can buy different coloured beds, and you can also buy paintings and different coloured banners. So, that's pretty cool, I guess. But more than anything, I just want to go ahead and get a ton of emeralds from these guys. So, yeah, that's what we're doing, basically. You see, this is what I'm on about, guys. We do have ourselves a bunch of villagers down here, which haven't been traded with yet. So they don't actually have a crest, which means they can have their trades changed or their profession changed, which is pretty awesome. But before going ahead and siphoning off some more villagers for a slightly different reason, I think we're going to go ahead and breed them up. So we need ourselves a bunch of bread. In fact, to tell you the truth, why don't we just buy some? We should just buy some bread. That's a much easier way of doing it, Python. Also, you got a bunch of hay bales in the last episode, you big doofus. Jeez. Oh, also, it's thundering. Interesting. I have channeling on my trident now. Should we try to get mob heads? Would that be a dangerous thing to do? I feel like that'd be a dangerous thing to do. But also, it's something I would actually really quite like to try and do. So here we go. There's the ocean scepter, which now has channeling on it. Considering the, the book that we got in the last episode. All right. Here we go, my friendos. Okay, so what we're looking for, let's just go for a plains biome over here. And we need Le Creepy. Oh, hello there, sir. Right. Boom. Okay. Here we go. You do your boom boom. Okay, yep, that'll do the job. Right, any of you blow up and leave your heads behind? Did they all survive that? Legitimately, I think they all survived. Unbelievable. I actually can't believe every single one of those guys survived that. Unfreaking believable. Well, now we have a ginormous crater in our world. Now, that ain't cool. Come on, man. I like to have a nice looking world, not whatever rubbish that was. Right, any more creepies? I need some more creepies. Come on, man. I want mob heads. I'm on the mob head grind now. I wasn't intending on being on the mob head grind, but eh? Oh, well. You think I care? No. All right. Boom. Oh, no. The thunder ended. That was the shortest thunderstorm in history. Come on, man. Well, there's me thinking I'd get something. Yeah, but Minecraft isn't going to let us have that. Nuh-uh. Bunch of jerks. How could they? That literally was the shortest thunderstorm in history in Minecraft. Ah, come on. I really wanted to get a moped there as well. All right, folks. So I have a plan. We are going to go ahead and install villagers down at the iron farm because, guys, honestly, it's about that time. We have ourselves blast furnaces, which give us armorers, smithing tables, which I think give us weaponsmiths, and grindstones that give us toolsmith. I can't remember because I don't really use the smith villagers very much because, quite frankly, they're usually quite terrible in terms of their trades. However, the reason I want them is because of their iron trade. So yeah, all we gotta do is head down here into the underbellies of this thing, and we need to go ahead and put in some little villager chambers. So here we go, we're back down here, which is obviously really cool. Yeah, like I say, all we're gonna do is put some villager chambers in. So maybe what we do is like add in, I don't know, like slabs and stairs and such, and then maybe we like open this up a little bit, put the villagers in, etc., etc. Yeah, I don't think we'll need too much space, honestly. Like, even that, I think, will do the job. They literally just need, what, a bed and a workstation, and then they're done. So, yeah, should be pretty simple, huh? All right, guys, so what do you think? Kind of a cupboard under the stairs kind of deal. We'll have the bed obviously going on there. We'll have ourselves the workstation there. And I'm hoping that they will still be able to pathfind towards their workstations, right? Because if they can't, then that'll kind of suck. If they can't, they'll suck. So, yeah. Okay, so here we go. We've got the blast furnaces and various other bits and bobs. All we got to do is place them in. So, smithing table. Do we want the bed there or do we want it there? I don't really know how this is going to work. I'm hoping that what will happen is if they sleep there, they'll spawn on here. So let's go and put the table like that. And then we'll put them all around the place. Okay, so we'll have one of the grindstones there. The other one can go there. Okay, now we've got the blast furnaces. One in there and one in there. All right, so that should be it. All we got to do is try to get the villagers in. That might be slightly more difficult, actually, because these guys are underground this time. All right, well, let's go pick up all of the minecarts, and let's see if we can't come up with a little bit of a system here. All right, folks, so for the most part, the process of getting the villagers over there has been pretty simple in that we go ahead, we find ourselves a villager that doesn't have a crest yet. We pop him out of his bed. Boop, rather like that. And then he goes into the minecart and off he goes. Okay, coolio, coolio. Right, we have that all figured out. So let's go ahead and place down the piece of wood that's supposed to be there. Okay. Right, in the meantime, guys, we can push this guy down to his correct area. And this might actually take a while. So here we go. Let's see where he goes. So this one actually wind up going underground. Dude, I can't talk today. My grammar has been absolutely dreadful. I don't even know what's going on. I haven't recorded in a couple of days, and that's because I've been, you know, busy with some other real life stuffs, visiting peeps and etc., etc., so on and so forth. But here we go. This guy is continuing on. So keep going, and then you will be inside of your area. Yes? Come on. Keep yourself going. You're nearly there. You're literally nearly there. Right, there we go. All right, so all that's left to do is to bop that off, get ourselves the blocks, FEB, boom, and boom, boom. Yes! Right, so that guy should now be fine. Awesome! Okay, let's just make sure. Yeah, and he's in his bed. Fan-freaking-tastic. Hey, you gotta love it, my friends. You gotta love it. All right, so one down. Five to go. Oh my gosh. Alrighty, guys, we've got villager number four coming in now. Oh my gosh, this has taken such a long time, guys, but honestly, I know for a fact that this is going to be worth it. So, yep, get those guys going. Bop that off. Get those in the offhand, and boom. Yes! Okay, coolio. Right, so all we got to do now is get these back ones in, and then we're good, right? So, yeah, we've got this guy going on. That guy's going on. Yeah, we're looking good, guys. So all that's left to do, really, is to A, get the rest of the villagers in, and B, get the underside upside-down stairs going again as well. So, yeah. All right, we're getting there. Oh, my gosh. Right, guys. So I think I've got just about everything done. So all we need to do now is see if the villagers have got their correct professions now. And if they have, then I guess we can start doing a little bit of trading. Ah, yeah, today's a villager trading episode. I mean, I do like villager trading episodes. I won't lie. I think they're pretty awesome because, you know, we get to make a whole bunch of progress, etc., etc., so on and so forth. But at the same time, I also really don't like them because of the amount of resources you go through in a very short amount of time. Ah, boy. But, well, my friends, we're looking good, aren't we? We really, really are. All we got to do is, like, put stuff away, and we can begin on the trading, I guess. Hey, check it out, guys. So I came over here just to check on them, and there appears to be 6 new turtles. Oh, my goodness me. Okay, so if we were to go ahead and try to force grow them all, then I should be able to get myself 6 more scutes, which is a pretty good amount, if you ask me. All right, so all I've been doing is going to a really, really shallow part of water, bone mealing it, and then shearing up all of the seagrass so I can then, you know, force feed the turtles and make them grow quicker. So, yeah, seems to work pretty well. All right, come on, little micro turtles. I'm going to force feed you all. There you go. I'm shoving the seagrass into your mouths. I'm sorry, that sounds a bit dark, doesn't it? Anyways, come on then. I want one more scoot and then I can make myself a turtle helmet. And that'll be amazing. That really actually will be. So, okay, so you just took like an entire stack. Oh my gosh. Okay, so these guys must have only just been... Oh, there you go. Yeah, okay, so you two could go breed up. Do your thing. Do your thing. Okay, fan-freaking-tastic. Okay, we're just going to get this guy going. Come on. We're just going to, like... Tell you, let's just, like, speed this up a little bit. There we go. Are you going to, like, grow up anytime soon? Come on. There you go. Right. Do your thing. Right, and how many have we got now? 6. Brilliant. Hey, this is pretty awesome. All right. Well, we'll just keep going until we run out of seagrass here. And then we'll move on to the villagers again. Uh-huh. Come on then. Oh, wait. You're getting a little bit too close for the... Yep, there you go. Hey, that's 7. All right. What do you think? Another one? Can we get one more? One more? We got, like, one more stack here. Come on then. Those guys are all, you know, fluffing around with the sand over there. So that's obviously a good sign. All right, so you're all good. Fantastic. All right, guys, we can make ourselves a turtle helm and therefore a turtle master potion. First time I would ever be able to make that. And also the first time I've ever made the freaking turtle helm either. Pretty cool, isn't it, guys? Pretty cool. All right, so let's go back here and bada bing, bada boom. There it is. The turtle shell. I feel like I should continue farming these things out, though, so I could, like, maybe make some different sets of armor. Like, maybe put respiration, aquafinity on this. Make myself a little bit of a diving suit, you know what I'm saying? I think that could be pretty awesome. But in the meantime, my friends, it's time to trade. Let's actually do this thing now. Ah, yeah. So we've got the little decorative, you know, underside things going now. So that's looking pretty cool. So all that's left to do is actually purchase some of this stuff. Oh, gosh. Well, most of these are going to be absolutely dreadful deals. Also, you are very loud, sir. So let's go ahead and turn that down a little bit. All right. So, yeah, plenty of stuff going on here. We basically just need to buy a bunch of this junk here. I can't believe it. We need to buy 8 loads of tools just to rank up. Dude, that's such a rip-off. Wait. No. Okay. No. Make that 10. We need to buy 10 crummy tools just to rank you up once. What? Hey, that's good, though. Look at that. 3 iron ingots for an emerald. Well, basically, guys, we can make this back immediately. Oh, my friends, we have basically just made ourselves probably the best XP farm going. And basically, we have infinite emeralds on this world now because this is infinitely producing iron. So therefore, we are infinitely producing emeralds. Look at this. And we're getting ourselves some more tools. Wow, that's a heck of a discount. Gosh darn. And once again, guys, a whole bunch of iron to trade. Ah, yeah, let's do this thing. And we just made our emeralds back in one foul sweep. All right, so what have we got this time? Hey, flint. I didn't realize these guys traded flint. Iron axe with unbreaking 2. Okay, that's pretty decent. What do you got over here? So coal and swords. All right, well, I mean, obviously it's going to be the coal because I've got like 12 stacks of coal ore going. What do you got going on over here? Just an axe. I need to buy 10 of those. My gosh. Okay, well, I mean, we might as well. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just pressing Q just to get rid of the axes here. All right, come on then. Rank yourself up. Yeah. And give to me. Give to me all the emeralds. They all belong to me. Oh, yes. Okay, brilliant. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's just chuck all of these things away. Don't need this many tools. We really, really don't. My goodness me. That's a lot of crud, isn't it? What do we got? Bells and more flint. Ooh. Okay, so I'm kind of interested to see what these guys will trade. Hey, they can actually still find their beds as well. Cool. I didn't realize that. Nice. All right, these rooms are literally perfect. Cool. Yep, I wasn't kidding, guys. We've got like 12 stacks of freaking coal ore. We might as well go ahead and use our diamond generator on it. Although this time it'll be more like a coal generator, won't it? Yay! All right, guys, let's do this thing, and we're going to see what other kinds of trades these smith people can give. Well, guys, one thing this coal has been good for is repairing my silk touch pickaxe. I mean, it's only repaired it by a little bit, but a little bit's better than nothing, isn't it? So there we go. Looking pretty cool. Let's get all of that place back on. And guys, we are going to finally see once again what the smiths can offer, because again, like I said, I just don't trade with them. Normally their trades are just god awful, but if we can get something that's got loot on or efficiency or something like that, I don't know, I think I'd be pretty happy with that. So here we go, back down to the foam of foaminess. Thankfully we only need to trade 5 times to rank these guys up, so there you go, all the iron once again. Okay, might as well. Boop, boop. Yeah, thanks broski. Hey, that's given us 30 levels. Awesome. All right, what else we got? We got this guy over here. Whoa. Huh, that's a heck of a discount. He's offering an iron axe for 1 emerald now. That is cool. Okay, right. Yep, that guy's been traded with. Is there anybody who hasn't been traded with just yet? Okay, this guy hasn't been. Okay, so he's going to give us iron next. I think iron trades are guaranteed, to be honest. So there you go. Yeah. Thanks, broski. Right, what are you going to give me next, huh? What are you going to give me? Lava bucket? That's an interesting trade. All right, and yet again with the coal. Uh-huh. Okay, and again, we'll get ourselves some iron just out of here real quick. Okay, let's get that all placed in. And what is on your next level? Shields. We can buy shields. That's interesting. Okay, so we've got loads and loads of emeralds, guys. I'm tempted to just do a bunch of trading off camera and see what their top trades are. So, do you know what? That's exactly what I'm going to go and do. I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit of a trading marathon, and we'll see what kind of trades they have in the finish. Alrighty, guys, and with 40 levels now under our belt, all of these guys are now at master rank. So guys, check it out, we've got some pretty decent trades going on here. This one is especially, you know, kind of all right. I mean, 31 emeralds is pretty bad, but if we were to make an infection chamber where we purposely infect these guys and then re-cure them, then their prices should be lower. So yeah, check this out, that's pretty decent. I'm breaking 3 efficiency, 3. That's pretty all right. Over here, we do have ourselves knockback and sharpness. Okay. I mean, fairly decent. But then we get round here, and check this out, guys. This guy has got a silk touch axe. Very nice. I am a big fan of that. Okay, and then round here, yeah, pretty basic stuffs, really. But for the most part, yeah, guys, I think we're just about there. So we can continuously and infinitely trade iron with these guys. And I tell you what, it sure is nice. I love me the XP. I'm so glad that you guys suggested that we go ahead and do this. I really, really am. So, guys, thank you very much for all of you who said, oh, hey, you should probably do this, because it's been more than freaking worth it. I think it goes without saying. Brilliant stuff. All right, guys, how many emeralds do we have now? 37 blocks worth. Awesome. All right, guys, let's grab the comment question of the video and then end off the episode, because we're done for today's episode just about. And ladies and gentlemen, once again at the end of the episode, we are greeted with Spike's company. Ah, yeah. So for episode 30, which, yeah, we're on episode 30 now, guys, Movie Clip says, I really want Python to make a Minecraft zoo. I think that'd be really, really awesome. So do I, actually. I think that'd be an amazing idea. And since we found, you know, a fair amount of savanna biomes in the last episode, we could also make it like a little bit of a drive-through safari. I don't know what they're called. I don't know what the actual word for them is. Like drive-through safari? I can't remember. I don't know. I'm drawing a complete blank right now. But you know, we like drive through the different pens and you have animals come up to your car and all that kind of stuff. That's basically the kind of thing I have in mind. But in terms of this woodland mansion, it could be a nice idea. We can make like little microbiome rooms and put polar bears in an Arctic themed one, put like llamas in a savanna themed one, all that kind of stuff. I think that could be a really, really nice idea. So yeah, For now though, my friends, it is time for us to end the episode. Guys, thank you very much for watching. If you have enjoyed today's episode, please do be sure, as always, to drop a like rating. I'd very much appreciate it. Hit the subscribe button and ding that bell if you guys don't want to miss out on future Minecraft content. But for now, my friends, that is going to wrap it up for today. Thank you very much for watching. Have a fantastic rest of your day, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.